Hey, Mike and Missy here. We recognize that this can be an intense time for marriages, and so we want to give you guys some practical tips to thrive through this crisis.
And if you have kids, we're going to throw in a bonus parenting tip that will help you disciple your kids throughout this time as well. So here we go. Hey guys, so what's the next problem? Well, last time we talked about how you're two sinners sort of stuck in the same space. But what if we just talk more generally that you're two very different people? This is from just even a personality standpoint. Those differences probably attracted you to each other in the very beginning. But now that you're in the same spot, like it's creating a little bit of a rub, right? It's those things, those little personality quirks are being highlighted more so. Or perhaps before you entered into this season or this time, you had grown more apart, right? So what does it look like now to kind of come back together in this? So what would be the prescription for that?
Yeah, the prescription you might not like very much because, I mean, some medicine we don't like, right? But this is your theological truth as married couples, is that you are one flesh. That's your prescription. You need to get back to being one flesh because you were designed to be that way spiritually. And this means that picture two balls of clay. You have two balls of clay and you're trying to make one ball of clay. You're trying to make a purple ball because you have a blue one, you have a red one, and try to make a purple one, which means that if you're making one flesh, you're making one whole ball of clay. You're not just taking two balls and making one huge ball. You're taking two and you're making one, which means you got to take some of the blue off and some of the red off. So practically, what does this look like? What does it look like to be one flesh? And how do you do this day to day? Well, it first starts with taking joy in the fact that you get to create a new family culture together. Like, guys, that's part of you exercising the image of God, that you are creating something new together. You're creating a new life, a new family culture. You may even create a new individual culture out of this, because as we talked about being partners in holiness, you're making each other better. You're making each other look more like Jesus. And that's just the, there's so much beauty there for you guys as marriage. So take the opportunity to say, what do we want our culture to look like? What do we want to bring to the table to create something beautiful together? And do that open-handedly. Do that with open hands. Allow God to take things out of there that shouldn't be in your marriage and to put something more beautiful in.
Yeah, and for your parenting bonus tip, that goes for the same thing with your children as well. First ask the Lord to help you learn your kids, to learn the uniqueness of them, how the scriptures say they're fearfully, and we are all fearfully and beautifully made, right? So ask the Lord what that looks like for your own children, and then celebrate that. Celebrate that with your spouse, celebrate that with your kids, but do that with your kids specifically by encouraging them with praise. Give them specific praise. And you can do that daily, you can do that weekly, whatever that looks like for your family in this new culture that you've created. But just be intentional behind the specifics that you give them as you encourage them. All right, thanks for joining us.